Okay, I've done this one about a million times. This is going to be the last time, no editing, no nothing, and here we go. The deal with setting up a template under Pro Tools is first you got to know what the heck it is you're dealing with as far as your interface. Now, the interface I have is a Motu 24IO. It has 24 ins and 24 outs, and I am not using all of them. They're configured in Motu's program that handles that, and you turn them on or off here, and it determines the bandwidth that this PCI card is using. I have the oldest PCI card, the 424, that you could possibly get, and I got it a long time ago because I used it with this live board, this Soundcraft Series 2. I eventually went and got myself a Presonus as soon as this thing came out because it was cheaper than an LS9. And this thing had the great ability to just pop in a firewire cable and boom, 16 channels recording. And over time, I ended up getting this headphone mixer, 4 monos and a stereo, much better than the Presonus unit that just gave you more me. It was kind of phasey and kind of weird. This is the actual brain of this system, and here's the 6 inputs, and it goes out these Cat5 connections. This board would run out of channels for me. When I would be doing live stuff and I would have a horn band or something and I'd have 4 toms or something, I ended up bringing the toms in through this little guy. I used put the 4 toms in here, panned them how I wanted them, and then put the left and right out and brought it back into this aux A and then routed this aux A out to a sub and I could control the toms. I could also record this stereo channel using Presonus's capture software through the firewire, so I had actually 18 channels. Toms were stereo, so I could either pan or do something differently when I was mixing down in Pro Tools once I brought the files in there. Lastly, I just bought a single tube preamp to use on the individual channels that were coming in as overdubs after the initial channels were recorded, and mainly you need a bunch of channels like this because we like to record drums first. I record usually 12 channels on drums, and then I'll record the band, whoever's playing with them at the time, a scratch vocal, scratch guitar, scratch bass, maybe 2 scratch guitars. But that's the deal. First, you got to know your interface and what you're dealing with as far as setting up a template. And you're probably only setting up a template because you have a lot of channels to set up to begin with. You're not going to be really needing a template if you just have like an inbox or something like that with 2 channels. You can just add them on the fly because then you'll know what you're dealing with there. So I'm going to create a blank session. 32-bit flow, 44-1 interleave. Doesn't really matter because you can pick that every time you pick your template. So blank session. Gonna call it what the heck should we call it? Always have to make up names. This is gonna go on here under Pro Tools, under screencasts, and I'll just call it template sample or something. And voila, I called it template sample. So now knowing what we have to deal with as far as interfaces go, and I'm not using all 24, I also have the headphone out. I'm using the Presonus's preamps out these D-subs into the Motu now, because these preamps sound better than these preamps, and this is determined by fader. This is also a huge board, and this is a little board, and then I can throw out these D-subs down here. Whoops. These D subs out here just go right out the preamp, and then I can bring this in TRS to here. So I have these 16. I also have this guy. I can bring out 2 more because it's only stereo left and right. I'm thinking maybe I can come out the inserts and get another 2 out of it, but I hardly ever need this when I'm studio tracking. Usually this is just for live. And then this guy, sometimes I put the vocal through it, depending on whether I need these 16 channels or not, but it's just a scratch vocal, so if I just need 16 channels, it'll go through this board. So with all that said, when you're in Pro Tools to set up a template, we're going to set up, easiest to be would be, let's just say 17, because that's what's always going to be happening for me, is the Presonus board and that one tube preamp. and I'll use the tube preamp to do the scratch vocal. So we're going to create 17 mono channels. In these mono channels, because you already know what you got, it already sets up the analog inputs for your interface. Your inputs are set up under your I/O, under setup and input. You can it has all the inputs from the Mo224 I/O, and you can use them as monos. There's stereo pairs, and it's got the mono individual channels underneath. 6, 7, 8. You can see I skipped 1920, and this was just to add in that Yamaha, because whenever you add in one of these pairs, it ups the bandwidth used, so that will just add to latency. And if I already said that, I'm sorry. So there's the inputs. My outputs, I'm only going to use these 6 outputs, plus the 2 for Pro Tools main output. These are all the way at the end of the Mo 2. They're 23 and 24, although it says 7 and 8 here, but this is just Pro Tools' way of analog output. And these are monos, just for the headphone amp. Buses, I have all kinds of buses set up already, and I delete the default ones that say bus whatever, because they're just distracting. This guy right here, that looks like it's from the Audrey Sessions demo session. It's not being used. So if you have something in italics, you know it's not being used and not assigned anywhere, you can delete those, and then you have to say okay. That's a tangent. So here's how I track sub, kick. Kick. Snare top, snare bottom. Then we're going to have tom 1, tom 2, tom 3. Sometimes I have more, and then that's when I'll either use a different channel on the Personas, or I'll bring in that Yamaha individually. Then I got my brass, which is hat, my left overhead, right overhead, my ride, and then I have a room mic, and that brings us out to 12 channels. Right off the bat, we can take these 12 channels and color them a nice little red color there. Then I'll bring in my bass, my scratch guitar 1, scratch guitar 2, and so far nothing in 16, and then 17 will be that tube interface, or tube preamp I should say, coming through the 24 IO interface, and that'll be my scratch vocal. You can color these to your heart's content. Guitars brown, and this is actually be scratch bass, and eventually we'll end up with a real bass. I will create a aux for the drums, a stereo aux, or if you're a live person, a subgroup. And I already have subs all set up here. That's my drum sub. I did that already. So now we'll just select all these guys, the drums, and send them out to the drum sub. You can, I'll usually mute the room so that during tracking, that isn't in his headphones. Throw the ride all the way to either sides, because these overheads, you'll hear these instruments, the ride and the hat, you'll hear them in the overheads, and they'll kind of go mono-ish on you. And if you use this to add, you'll get more of a spread. Toms, I always do audience perspective when I'm mixing, So audience perspective would be throwing the low tom to the left and the high tom to the right, and then this guy a little bit over. Snare is always a little bit over. Hardly at all. It's still pretty much mono, but just a little hint of being on that side. Subkick's pretty loud, so we'll crank that down a little bit. Snare bottom, could even mute that, but just bring it down a bit. Toms are good. Hat I would bring down, and ride I would bring down. This is for tracking. So this is what he's going to hear in his headphones. And like I said, this is muted. And then that's the drum setup. And this goes out my 5 and 6 and is stereo, and that's why I'm doing it this way. And everybody can hear the drums. I did forget something, which was you're going to need a click. In fact, I could just add a aux and then insert the click plugin, but Pro Tools has track, create click track, and then it pops it right next to the selected track. I put my click at the top of the session, and I will assign the outs after, because we need a main, obviously, to control the master level of all this stuff that we're actually not going to hear while tracking. And it defaults to your first stereo, I believe, and I have to assign that to main, so now everybody's going out main. Being that I'm not using 16, I could just... I'll just hide that, and that way if I need it in the session, I'll unhide it and use 16 for something else. Now I'm going to add the headphone auxes for monitoring. This one's a stereo, so we have four monos and one stereo, as I showed you on that unit, and then I create a mono aux for a talkback. Aux input, that is correct. And then I'll color these all a weird dark color. And for some reason I call it HF. I don't know why, but I do. Four, five, and six, and then my talkback. These guys now go directly out the interface, so assign this to my analog 1 out, analog 2, analog 3, analog 4, and then finally 5 and 6. The talkback is going to go out of bus 5 and 6. So these are the buses set up for these headphone HS, headphone sub. 1, 2, 3, 4, and finally 5 and 6, which is where to go, right there. My talkback comes in on, it comes through my Presonus, and I send it out and aux 1, so I got a TRS going from aux 1 into my Mo224IO into analog 18. I'll show you this here. So the Presonus here, there's a talkback input right here. So I can take this talkback input and have a talkback button to turn it on and off, and you can route that through, it's kind of hard to see here, let me see if I zoom. You can route the talkback out auxes 1 and 2, auxes 3 and 4, auxes 5 and 6, or the mains. So I'll route out aux 1 and 2. And when this goes out aux 1 and 2, let's come back minus. There's the aux here. It's just, this is set to unity, and then it goes out that aux, which is down here. Aux 1 is a TRS, out of that TRS into input 18 right here. So I got 1 through 16 inputs from the Presonus, 17 coming in from the tube pre, 18 coming in from the talkback circuit through this Personas. This Personas also controls my return from Pro Tools, which comes through the 24IO. I bring that into aux input A, and that is recorded, or that is returned right here. Set that to unity, and then that's where Pro Tools comes back. And I use this to control my listening monitors. Monitors come out here. You can also have a dual output on TRS for here, main out. So you have two different main outs. You could use two different sets of speakers. I also run huge speakers for playback for people that want it loud. I have coming out here control room output. So I have sends out my left, right for that. And that is controlled with this knob right here, monitor, or cue. I can't remember. But it's one of those. It might be cue or monitor. Wait, I think it might be monitor. You pick what you want to hear. And I pick main, and then you can turn it up and down here. Anyway, that's just a benefit of using this board for all these things, controlling the monitors and different sets of monitors and using it as the preamps. And also my computer, it's hooked up FireWire still, and my computer audio I have coming back through channels 1 and 2. And that can come back. Again, it's got talkback in there. And that ability. So anyway, this was just to show you how the talkback comes back through that aux one. So now if I go over to my Personas board and hit my talkback, we should see level. And we do. So we see the level there. So that is going out 5 and 6. I also send it to each of the other individual channels. So there's no getting away from my talkback. These artists, these guys, they think they're slick, but no. I'm going to be the voice of God right in their ears. So 4, and now you can see again, if I hit the talk back, they all go up like that. So that brings the talk back through all of those guys. Now, through my stereo, I'll send my drums to my 5 and 6. What I do with that is I reverse the pan. Because I mix audience perspective, and when I reverse the pan, he's sitting back there and he hears his drums, drummer perspective, and all the other guys monitoring do as well. But hey, we're only tracking, doesn't really matter. I always like to make my vocal number one on that unit, so the vocals are always number one, and the bass is always number two, and then I have two guitars. I have a 3 and a 4. Sometimes I'll only have one guitar, and then I'll route the click out 4 so that everybody can have a separate click. But if I have two guitars and a bass and a vocal, that means I've maxed out my 4 monos and I have only drums left, and basically only the drummer should hear the click. So I'll send the click out to 5 and 6. The new click plugin is pretty nifty, and it's got a BPM there, and it also has a lot more sounds available that you can use. But this isn't a tut on the click. This is a tut on a template. So now my template is pretty much done. I have all the channels that I'm going to track drums with, because I'm tracking drums first, really, and just using these guys as a placeholder for that. And the good thing about this is, and playing to a click, is that these guys, they only have to play through once. And then if the drummer wants another go at it, you can just not record these guys again. And another thing to do, or you might want to do, is group the drums. Little trick here is to set them as D drums, and that will be effective if you use the what's this called, the quick key or hot key or whatever when you're over on the mixer. See how it's turned on here. Keyboard focus, that's what it's called. Thank goodness for pop-ups. So now it's set to letter D, D drums. So D turns it on and off. You can see them going on and off right here. So D drums, you could set up G guitars, you know, whatever, whatever you want to do. They are grouped together so that that also works in an edit. What I normally do is have all tracks that I am tracking selected. So since they're all selected, we can use the... I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's just say this is a template first. File, save as template. And Wombat is where I put my stuff. Select location, which I guess you could change where these normally go. Default's fine for me. Include media is if you say you had sucked into this template a reference track and you had all of the different wave files in that track. You could include that media with the template so that every time that you suck that template in, it will have that media in it. If you track first and you think this is great, I'm going to save this for the next song that we're moving on to, don't include the media or you'll include the entire session basically. But if you're just setting up from scratch and you put in a reference track, then that would be a good idea to include the media. But I have no media in this, so I'm going to say it comes up as template sample. I'll say okay. And now we've saved this as a template. And now I can save this session, and I'll just close it just so we can start from scratch and I can show you an example. So now you're on tracking day, you got all ready. And you have your template set up. So you want a new session. And you're going to create that session from a template. And you know you created a template. Like I'll call them band names or something like that. And you can say template sample. You, like I said, you can change the sample right now. My interface only goes up to 96. Not that I would ever record at 96. 32-bit float is what I prefer. And interleave files, which puts stereo files together. And all that is complete. You say, okay, it's going to ask you for a new location where to put it. I'm going to call it template. Let's say track sample. Track sample. Boom. Now we have this tracking sample. You can see these are still selected from when I selected them. Because they're all selected, and I don't need the color thing here. And here's the nifty new CPU meter in Pro Tools 11. Because they're all selected, you can hold down Option. Option means all tracks, and then Shift means selected, and then we can hit Record or Record, depending on how you pronounce it. Now you're all ready to go. Your click is all ready to go at 120, unless you need to change it to something else. But you can change it to something else. And now you can hit Record, and now, boom, we're tracking. Click, 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 which is going out. Boom, boom, to the drummer on 5 and 6. And they are now playing their masterpiece and recording it. And, oh, messed up. So you stop it. Or you could have hit command period and not saved any of this stuff. Or you could say, okay, that beginning was awesome, so I want another take. in order to start them all over again, because we've not completed an entire scratch track for the other guys. Again, Option, all the tracks, Shift for selected, and then you use the Control / to create a new playlist. Boom. Now you got a new playlist immediately. They don't have to wait for you to set up or anything. We're ready. Okay, take two. Boom. You start recording. And again, at any time that anything happens or whatever, you can stop it and go back, create a new playlist, like I said, with the Option Shift Control / which will create new playlists for all the tracks. And let's pretend that this song is minutes, seconds. Let's pretend this song is 30 seconds long. Okay, they're done. Boom, stop. It's great take. Oh, it's great. oh, you, whatever. So, but the drummer's like, I'm not sure. So here's where this comes in. We can turn off the record for the vocal, the guitar, and unselect them, because we have their scratch, and that's fine. But the drummer, he's uncomfortable with his performance. So now we can go back again, since we've deselected each of these channels, turned off record. Just for the drums, we can option shift control backslash. And now we have a new playlist for just the drums, and he'll play along with the pre-recorded or the from the prior take of the vocals, bass, and two guitars. You hit record, and now the drummer is doing his next track, and he's playing along. See, we're all thinking this in our heads because there's no audio here. I don't have a band here to do this with. And, oh, he messed up. Well, we're not going to keep that one. So, you know, command, period, boom, it's all gone. We can use it on the same take, track it. And, oh my God, that was the best roll I've ever heard in my life. And he just started laughing, thinking that was the best roll he ever heard in his life. And he stopped. I don't know why. But let's stop this, save that roll, and then again, option, shift, control, backslash, next take. And you see that it incremented all of them to number 3 here. And start from the top. And we record again. So this is the way you can record you track just the drums, and as long as you have a scratch for each of the other individual channels, you can do the drums until the drummer's satisfied with his performance. Usually 2 or 3 takes, I'm sure you'll get through it. And then you'll have those other tracks to go to if you need to go and get that awesome fill he started off with that he could never duplicate again. But you'll be able to get it there. So we'll stop it there. He's done. And we can turn off record. Option shift click for record. And then option click. They're all deselected. And now we have our completed song. Alt A to zoom into the entire song. And there it is. So with these are groups. So if we go to, no, not the little arrow. You go to here and select playlists. You'll see all the other playlists that exist for the drum part. And it does that because they're grouped. So when they're grouped, whatever you select here, they will all do that. Same goes for these guys. You'll see in the playlist we have that other take that didn't go anywhere. And we have what we need to complete this and start mixing. Within the template, you could have put all kinds of plugins and stuff so that you're all good to go and ready to mix. But for tracking, you obviously don't want any plugins. Also for tracking, you obviously want to take down your buffer. And this is at 64. Amazing. I usually track at 128. But 11 is hardly touching my computer at all at this high sample rate. So I look forward to actually tracking a band in this. The only thing I've tracked so far is pre-recorded stuff from a digital recorder. So that's how you set up a template, and that's how you utilize it to track, and how you can track scratch guitars and stuff, and then do multiple drum takes if the guitar players are sitting around saying, do I have to play again? Because I'll get that. And that should do it. Once you're done, you save your session. I like to increment my session numbers with each edit, with each entrance and exit of it, and that way I can incrementally go back to different levels and then close this session and then start up a new one. Just for the heck of it, I'll show you real quick a new session, and I'll use this BSR2. It's obviously I was tracking somebody, and this is how we ended up. BSR2. I'm gonna save, replace. No, let's call it BSR3, just to bring something up and show it to you real quick. And this is the session I had. You see that everything's everything is highlighted or selected. Here's the mixer. Here's this. This doesn't really fit on the screen too well. Sends. Let's get rid of these inserts. I don't think there's anything there. That kind of makes it fit. Looks like the only sends are on the second group of sends. So let's get rid of the first group of sends. And now you can kind of see this here. He had 5 toms. So I ended up adding on another 2 toms. And because of that, that's when I went to adding the Yamaha to add that other channel for another guitar player. So I had 5 toms. I had 2 guitar players, a bass player, and a vocalist. And you can see he went in 17. I brought that guy in 21 through that guy, and 1 through 16 were used for basically 14 channels in the drums, right? Yeah. And then 15, 16, this guy came in the, and that filled up the Presonus. Then this guy came in the Tupri. This guy came in the little, Yamaha. Click was just sending that to the drummer. The drummer was getting 5, 6, guitar, bass, vocal, guitar. They're playing through amp sims. So they just went in DI. This is part of my mix template from here to here. My print track, my print monitor, and because of the new Pro Tools offline bounce, I may not need this, or I'll still use this in some capacity, in some sort of way. And then here's my headphone out, like I showed you before, and how they were all routed, and this plugin I'm going to miss big time, TalkBack. What that did was when we had TalkBack engaged and they were working something out, if the drummer decided to go like this and start hitting his drums, boom, it would mute the TalkBack so that our ears didn't get blown out. But now I have to be quick on the button again. So hopefully Mr. Massey will AAX that sucker. And that should do it as far as setting up a template and how you would utilize it to track. And if you have any questions, just get a hold of me somehow. And I think that should do it. And I hope that helped you out. I'll see you next time.